We'll see the adjustment is an alteration to add more room in the back of the pants, skirt or dress. I'm using the same pants by Mood Fabrics, here on their website. I've cleaned it up for the better visibility, but you don't have to. Preparation. You don't even have to ungroup if you have new Inkscape 1.1. I find the size line I need and control click it, then change its color with shift click on the color swatch in the bottom. We can't see it yet, but we will after either ungrouping or popping the object out of the group. It's in menu object, but we've created a handy shift alt G combination in the video about Inkscape shortcuts, and I use it a few times. It's better to lift the object to the very top until it says selection not in a group in the status bar below. Finally, we need to trace a dart. Switch to Bezier tool or press B and click at the corners of the dart, letting Inkscape to snap happily. We are going to use division path operation in this tutorial, and where division is used, it's always better to turn snap to path on. Division will only work well if paths intersect directly, and being one point away will not do. You can also check it visually. Zooming in increases snapping accuracy. If you like my tutorials, consider subscribing. It warms my heart and just so happens to help my channel grow. Press enter in the end and switch back to select tool or press S. Then select both pants leg and the dart with shift. Duplicate with Ctrl D and pull them away. Cutting line. We'll need several guides to create the lines to cut and pivot. From the ruler at the top, pull the horizontal guide to the dart point. Then make the path. Along the guide to the dart point, then angle it through the top point of the side seam. Add the main pattern shape to the selection and pass division. If you did everything right, you'll have two distinct shapes and can color them separately. If not, undo and pull the end nodes of the cutting lines to intersect the pattern piece and try again. We need a knee mark or its estimate for the next horizontal guide. Make it right at the side of the pattern piece. Then pull a vertical guide through the same point. A tiny, tiny red square under the cursor is a guide origin. It also serves as the rotation center. Hold shift and pull the vertical guide to the side seam until it's parallel-ish to the crotch curve, not an exact angle. Make a path along the guide. Use it to divide a bigger pattern piece again. It's better to explicitly intersect the pattern shape. Division works better this way. I use division a lot, so memorized Ctrl/shortcut. The last line is rather arbitrary, it's vertical and through the more straight part of the crotch curve. Create a path and divide the previous shape with it like we did before. Adjustment amount. I follow the tutorial by Alexander Morgan and use the same total 1 inch amount. He suggests adding half of that to the first cutting line, so let's mark half of an inch higher than the dart point. To do this, double-click the horizontal guide. Switch millimeters to inches, and to raise the line, we'll need to subtract half of the inch from the Y coordinate. No math needed, just write -.half after the number in the field and click OK. We are going to pivot the shape there, but first to preserve the dart. Select both the dart and the shape underneath and path division. It should have left, dart, and right. Duplicate dart 2 times. With right and dart selected, paths combine to keep them together. Move the result a bit to the side and repeat with left and dart. Snap the right plus dart back in place. If it won't snap, check if snapping is on. Ascend to toggle or zoom in to increase snapping accuracy. Spread and pivot. Now we have two combined shapes. Select both of them and click again to get the rotation handles, or press Shift S. Second click might confuse Inkscape, so I prefer the shortcut. The selection has its own rotation center, grab it and pull to the top left corner. Pull the bottom right rotation handle up until the shape snaps onto the guide. Click away to deselect and click only the right shape twice. Pull the rotation center to the new dart point. Notice that the rotation center is outside the shape. Pull the bottom right handle down until it snaps to the guide. Now select both lower pieces near the crotch point. Shift S to get rotation handles and bring the rotation center to the knee point. Pull the top right handle until the shape aligns with the crotch curve. We will use another half of the adjustment for the last pivoting. Click the smallest shape only twice, or click and shift S, find the rotation center below, and pull it to the lowest point of the shape. First, take the vertical guide going through the knee and pull it to go through the top left point of the smallest shape at the crotch curve. From there, we need to move it 1/2 of an inch away to the side seam, to the right on my pattern. Double-click the guide, change units to inches again, and this time add 0.5 to X coordinate. Pull the top right handle until the shape snaps to the vertical guide. The next step is to trace the changes. Switch to Bezier tool, press B, and put notes where the curve is changing, from the top of the side seam to the knee point of the inseam. When you get to the end, simply click the starting point. With Node tool, press N, curve the segments to follow the lines through the crotch curve as you are doing so. Add a point in the middle of the dart with a double click and pull it up slightly to create a dart roof. The dart roof should visually continue the lines of each side. If you'd like me to cover a particular topic or a certain adjustment, tell me in the comments. I always answer to comments. When you are finished, select both new shape and unaltered part of the pant leg with Shift, and then pass Union. It may look as if the new shape disappeared, but the combined shape is just below others. We also need to retrace the dart the same way as in the beginning. I'm not sure if it should keep the original dart point or not, the original tutorial doesn't say. I guess you'd pin it on the body and decide which way looks better on you. Here you can see the comparison of the original and adjusted shapes. We have added some length in the crotch curve and more room in the hips, but only slightly increased the crotch depth. If you need to add more room in the front too, watch the full timing adjustment video when it's out. Read the name of my kind supporters and maybe you'd like your name to appear alongside them. Thank you for watching!